Good afternoon, world. Welcome back to my channel. Today, we're gonna take you to our little trip in the Saturday afternoon to the Vatican City. And then we're gonna bring you to our rooftop afternoon spritz and then an Asian buffet restaurant after all. So stay tuned. Today we decided to take the subway instead of to go there by car because we know that tonight if we're having spritz and everything, we're gonna drink a little bit, so maybe cars isn't a good idea. So we just take the subway from nearby our place. The weather was like 18 degrees by the time. You don't need to wear a lot of clothes, just a little cardigan is good enough. It was Saturday, so I guess there isn't too many people because there are no students. Welcome to Ottaviano. We get off to Ottaviano and walk to the Vatican City from here. I always have a huge love towards the little street in Rome. It was so beautiful, the architecture is amazing. It has been there for hundreds of years and bring together with its historical meanings and also the beauty of the old time. If anyone let me to go back to any time that I want to, then no hesitation for me to say I want to go back to the 16th or 17th century. Can you imagine how beautiful it is to sit outside, breathing the air and having some spritz? When I was a kid in a little town in Hanoi, Vietnam, I was always wanted to be one of the girls who walking like super fashionable on the street of Paris or Rome, and here I am living my dream.
Let's cross with the nuns, because therefore they could beg God. They will never be run over.
Actually, there's one thing that I have never known before. Of course, I was like very lack of knowledge about Europe, history in general, but about the Vatican City, I found that I was very lack of knowledge. I didn't even know that Vatican City is not a city, it's actually a country. So, just so you know, the Vatican City, officially Vatican City State, is an independent city-state, microstate and enclave within Rome, Italy. It became independent from Italy in 1929 with the Lateran Treaty. And it is a distinct territory under full ownership, exclusive dominion, and sovereign authority and jurisdiction. Which means it has its own law, it has its own system of every single thing.
Look at the wife.
Itself is a sovereign entity of international law, which maintains the city-state temporal, diplomatic, and spiritual independence. The area is only 49 hectares, and as 2019 population, about only 453. It is the smallest state in the world, both by area and population. I think nowadays go around like 900, 1,000 people or something, but still.
Not your country anymore, huh?
I can feel a very holy vibe walking in through here. Everything was so thick, so beautiful, so artist. Every single piece of it is like a masterpiece. You can see the statues on top of the buildings and every single detail. Those two women wanted to go in there, but of course the Swiss, I think people call them the Swiss guard, stopped them. Beautiful. Feel like I was in the scene of Spectrum or something. The Vatican Museum opening hour is from Monday to Saturday, so you can check it out in the website. Today we didn't go in because we want to save everything the Vatican Museum and also the gardens around for the spring because we want to see when it's the most beautiful.
Totally no, now we are back in Italy.
Goodbye, Vatican.
I took wifi around the beach, around the continent. Gildo.
Outside of Vatican City is still a bunch of tourists. I mean, of course, it was a Saturday also. And I think in the summer it's gonna be much more than this because there will be more, like, I don't know, holy events and festival inside.
Very cute.
Now we're heading to the rooftop garden restaurant that we booked a week ago. I love every single detail about Rome, like the water fountains in the middle of nowhere, in the middle of the all, everywhere actually. And the people around sitting outside all chilled with the good drinks in their hand. Would love to live here.
Oh yeah, for sure. I think for less than 2 million euros, you get you don't even get a garage.
Of course, this should be very expensive. Back to the road.
Oh yeah, a plate of carbonara. They're fucking out of their mind. I understand this.
Where should we go from here?
Wait. Two minutes. Perfect. Right here. No, I will miss the street.
Beautiful.
Like it.
Yes. But who took me here?
Of course, of course.
Beautiful. I love the tree on the spring. The leaves just start coming out and it has a very, very light green color, which bring so liveliness.
They look so soft and juicy. Because they're young, I guess. Like, look at how soft they are.
Yeah. Juicy.
Here we are at the roof garden.
Wait a second.
It was a very peaceful and beautiful Saturday afternoon. We arrived here around 6:30, 6:25 something, because our booking was 6:30. With this place, I heard that you should always book it a week before the booking time. You can book it through the website. You don't have to call or do anything. So just go to the website, booking, put your card information just as a guarantee, and that's it. You can do it. And you can have this beautiful view with us. I think we have the best table here. Everything was so beautiful. We just super speechless of the scene, just sitting there looking out to the Vatican City and all the buildings around.
The way to the toilet is so cool.
Cold?
Cool. See everything.
This is the perfect date place, of course. Especially for the first date. I swear at least two or three of the table there is for the first date. The food is so good, even the fries was crazy. The shrimp that they gave me, the little prawn, like, tastes so good. Of course, it's not gonna be the cheapest thing that you can pay in Rome. For the whole table like us, you pay 80 euros. but look at the views and the scene and everything. And the quality of the food was beautiful. I love the shrimp so much. Staying there, talk about everything in the world, having the best food. So we finished, of course, every single piece. And when we finished, the sun's already set and everything. So now we see the beautiful night view of the place. Such a perfect hour to come. I suggest you to come around 6:32. It's perfect.
I've never got this good view.
And now we're gonna go to La Dogana, which is the longest Asian buffet restaurant in Rome. My husband told me that he used to go there quite often when he was a student, and there was a bunch of different, like even Thai food and some Vietnamese food, Chinese food too, so I was super excited. They even have the outdoor area, which is very nice. So coming here, you pay 26 euro each person, and you can have the multiple choice of dumplings, sushi, sashimi, and some different stuff in the menu, which you're gonna order direct in the menu. And you can also can go around the buffet area, so you can have anything you want, the frito, which is fries, everything you want. And you can even pick up some fresh fish so they can grill it right there for you. The dessert, of course. Very Italian, but very good. I'm not a big fan of dessert though, so I wouldn't be able to review all the dessert. The sashimi was good. It was very, very good.
Goodbye, Epi.
Epi, baby.
Be more Italian.
So full!
So full! Cannot breathe!
Full, 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 full.
Can you breathe?
No, never, never.
No, no, and now absolutely we're going cannot. Home to our sweet home after eating like a beast. Maybe two beasts.
But going home.
Okay, see you next time! If I say next time!
Next time!
Thank you so much for watching this video and to take this adventure with us. Please like and subscribe for more in the future. Stay tuned.